Welcome to Focus on Funds, the Investment Company Institute's weekly roundup of industry news, ICI activities, and research findings. The landmark U.S. legislation protecting employees' pension assets and improving their receipt of benefits has just turned 40. The Employee Retirement Income Security Act, known as ERISA, was signed into law on Labor Day 1974. ERISA took bold steps to safeguard Americans' employer-sponsored pensions and create the Individual Retirement Account, or IRA. It set the stage for remarkable growth in assets that Americans have set aside for retirement. At the end of 1974, assets earmarked for retirement totaled $0.4 trillion. Private sector defined benefit plans and government plans each accounted for a bit more than one-third of the total. Private sector defined contribution plans accounted for 17% of assets and annuities 13%. There was a mere glimmer of IRA assets by the end of the year in which they were created. Contrast that to today. U.S. retirement assets total $23 trillion. IRAs now account for the largest single component of U.S. retirement savings, representing close to one-third of the total. Defined contribution plans are the second largest component, with 401k plans representing the lion's share.
ERISA was a seminal moment in the development of U.S. pension policy. Further improvements and innovations have followed, with regulatory agencies, including the Department of Labor and the Treasury, playing important roles. It's been a true public-private partnership involving policymakers, employers, financial services firms, and individual savers. The past 40 years of U.S. pension policy have helped Americans build retirement nest eggs. Today, more retirees get more income from private sector retirement plans. When ERISA was signed into law, about one-fifth of retirees received income from private sector retirement plans, while today, about one-third do.
That's This Week in Funds. See you next week.